Hello everyone, this is CypherDeck, and today we're going to be playing Scrap Mechanics. I am back, and with my motorcycle, we're going to go ahead and search out for some sort of place that we can call our home. And I think I already found it. It's right there. I like the space needles. The space needles make it rather easy for you to build on. They're nice and flat. Of course, my motorcycle is not the easiest to control out of all the vehicles that I've made. It is rather the most fun vehicle I've ever made. Alright, there we go. Let's go ahead and get up on here. Jump right into a tree. This thing loves trees. Alright. Go ahead and grab it. And we'll go ahead and put it up here. There we go. So today I want to go ahead and build some sort of structure, some sort of home, a vehicle that can, I don't know, maybe a coaster. Let's go ahead and build the vehicle for it, and then we'll make track for that vehicle. So I'm gonna go ahead and put down my little old lift, and let's go ahead and decide what kind of blocks we want to use today. So these are the lightest blocks, or lighter blocks. I'm guessing these are probably lighter because of the fact that they have pretty much air between the framework. But I think I'll go ahead and just go with something, let's go with something simple. Well, that's what we'll go ahead and do. Let's see. Go ahead and go with these. Always going to need bearings of some sort. May need suspension of some sort. Yep. Of course, our controller. And small wheels. We'll use that to start out with, and then we can build on from there. Something that I never noticed before is that these are built out in categories. The blue are all these specific blocks. You have these reddish colors, which are mechanical blocks, and then the rest of them are construction blocks and also non normal blocks, I guess you would call them, because who needs a mannequin foot for anything other than, you know, things that you would use mannequin feet for. Anyway, moving on, let's go ahead and build out our seat, and then we will decide how we want to go ahead and proceed from there on. So we should be able to get our seat to fit right there. All right, so I want to build something that hangs upside down, something that you would see like in a roller coaster. So we're going to go ahead and go up. Something like that. Oh, no, that's not the same height. Looks better. Actually, what I'll do is just come across here and then remove what I don't need. That works perfect. Perfect. Alright, there we go. So we need it to turn, I'm guessing. Alright, we'll go ahead and add a little bit more onto the front here, because we are going to have some sort of engine on it, I'm guessing. Alright, so I'll go ahead and put a bearing here and here. Maybe not back there. So we'll go ahead and bring these up one more. And then we'll go ahead and have this. All right. Easy enough, right? I'll go ahead and connect these directly together. They are kind of close to each other, though. These wheels, so it may not drive the best. So, that's pretty much it as far as that goes. The next thing is our motor, which I'm going to go with an electric motor just to see how it runs, how it works for our situation. And I'll go ahead and put it right there. Go ahead and connect this to that. Connect this to those. Connect this to those. And then make sure all of our bearings are going the correct way. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and just put this on the ground for a second and just see which way they're turning. So it looks like they're turning the right way. Alright, so now we need to build something for them to ride on. Something like a rail system of some sort. So I'm going to go ahead and go right next to this. Is that high enough? Okay. Okay, there we go. Is that too high? Yep. All right, and whole thing is wrong anyway. All right. So now we should be able to create a rail system going across here. All right. Make sure that those are exactly the same. Alright, so now all we do is just go maximum. And do the same here. And we'll go ahead and put a block going across just to see if this is working. Go. Put just a little bit of speed on it and just see how this works. All right. So that seems simple enough. Nothing really is caused any problems there. What if we go upward now? So the way I suggest that we do this is we put a bearing here, bearing here, come out, All right, we're gonna need our box here. And we'll go ahead and connect this. Connect that. All right, so we went out three, was it? Two, three. Then we need to come across two. There we go. We'll do the same thing here. Go across two. And that should be at the same height there. So now what we want to do is we want to go ahead and get these going at the same angle. And we'll go ahead and have this come up. Let's say 30 degrees first, because I don't know how these things are going to take the weight. There we go. And we'll need a button. Connect that to that. All right. Now we get to see if this worked. We need to take that bar off. All right, let's go ahead and sit down. And that worked perfectly. All right, so, let's see. Do we want to... If we put wheels underneath it and we put those on shocks, I wonder if we can make this thing do a circle. All right, so that's our challenge now, is to go ahead and create a circle. So I'm going to go ahead and have this come back straight. And we're going to do the same thing again. We're going to go ahead and have this go here. We can put up to 10 bearings on the same box. Go ahead and get that off there. Come out three. Come out three. Yeah, we have to go all the way over here. There we go. Then come across two. And what I'm doing whenever I'm doing this is I'm actually aiming at the block that's on the bearing. And then we're going to come out again. We're going to come all the way out to the maximum. All the way out to the maximum. And they should stay exactly at the same length. So now what we do, and this is where we're going to start having a little bit of fun, is we're going to come here, and these are going to go 45 degrees. So this will take the vehicle 90 degrees, or no, it'll take it, so yeah, 40, 80, 90 degrees, yes. I'll take it 90 degrees. So before we do that, before we try it, by the way, this is what it's going to look like. Oh, we need to go ahead and flip this one. It's close to 90 degrees. We want to go ahead and now decide to go ahead and put some kind of suspension on this. So I'm going to go ahead and put something there. I'm going to put my jack right here. Make it easier for me to get up here and take a look at how everything's going to work. You know, I don't think that's going to work. So let's go ahead and take that there. I think it has to come down to here. Okay. All right, well, let's try something first. Because I don't think the original option is going to work. That there. Put a wheel. And these wheels are not going to have any movement on them. They're just going to be there for support. At first. We may add movement afterwards. But for right now, they're there for support. And let's go ahead and try it out. Because it seemed like it moved on to this really easily. Okay. This is where it's going to be really the test. So it needs that bend. It needs that suspension to work. So I'm going to have to, I have an idea of how to get it to work. It's not going to be... anything fancy or good looking, but I am going to have to change this a little bit, so we'll go. Two, three. Do the same thing here. One, two, three. One, two, three. All right. So what I'm doing, or why I'm doing this, we'll go ahead and bring the left over here, is because now we're going to go ahead and put the suspension on. All right. We need this up one more. I can already see it. All right. So we need to put that up one more. I know, I didn't need to go down one, but it's already there, and I'm not going to change it. So now we need to go ahead and get rid of that, and that, that, and that. Put a block here, here. We're going to get off of there, and we're going to put a bearing there. And a wheel there. Alright. Now we just need to do the same thing. Bearing here. And a wheel. Alright. So, that should allow it to flex. We already know that it works with just those two wheels. Alright. So, we already know that over here, we need to put a block right there. Right there. Okay, get on this. Go up a little bit. Get these off of here, because we already know we need to take them off. So, what I'm thinking is we are going to need... to put we're gonna have to put the motors on these if we're going to make this work correctly. The reason is because if it goes upside down, it is going to have a way to still have traction, which is what these are for. So all right, now that we have those, we're gonna go ahead and put I don't know why I'm making this harder than it needs to be. Alright. Let's go ahead and get rid of that. Now then, go ahead and connect this to these. Oh boy. It's not gonna work, is it? It's not. All right. So what we need to do is we now need to go ahead and make this. I think that's how it is on that other side. Let's go ahead and get in here. Get out. Yep, I'm missing a whole section. And one more. And we're going to go ahead and put another one of these motors down. We'll take off any excess blocks that we don't need. I'm going to do this for the side as well. And I'm going to do it for the other side, for that other engine. Just to reduce as much weight as we can. Alright, so there we go. And then we need to go ahead and attach this motor to the steering wheel and to each one of these wheels. And these need to be turning in the opposite direction of the wheels on top. So these need to be going backwards. And these on the other side should already be going backwards. Yep. All right. So now we need to go ahead and just set this one up. I think it was from the third from the top. Nope. It's 1, 2, 3. All right, there we go. So now, first, you can already see it's going a whole lot better than it was before. The suspension is helping out. It's kind of wobbling. And I really don't know what I could do to make it better. But we don't want it to go off. The thing is, though, that now we've made this, we can go ahead and complete our 180 and see how it goes. Or, yeah. So let's go ahead and push this button here. Get rid of that block. And now we're going to go ahead and do the same thing that we did before. So we'll go ahead and put that there. That there. Run these all the way back to here. And again, we're only going 45 degrees. That's 75. 45. There we go. And we'll go ahead and just do what we've been doing. That's 3, I think. 1, 2, 3. Alright, so let's see how this goes now. I already know that that one's going to be wrong, so I need to come up here. Hopefully it's not too high. It is. This is going to be fun. I'm going to like this, I think. I think this is going to be the last one for today, just because of the fact that, I think you have the idea. I think you understand how it's created, what we're doing with it. And this is only one rail system of many that I've seen online that you can definitely check out. So let's go ahead and see if we can make it to that top one there. I know it's going to be a struggle. If we can make this. Oh, it wants to. So bad. Oh, yeah. That is so freaking scary right there. All right. That's as far as it's going, it looks like. It's still going, but let's go ahead and back up. And just see how fast we can get it back down there. So I have the speed down, but you know what? Let's go ahead and do it. Let's see what we can do with that speed, and then we'll go ahead and end it for today. I think we'll go ahead and go. I don't know. Let's go to there. On both engines. Maybe speed is the way you need to do. Oh my goodness. It's shaky. Oh, it's coming off. It's off. Which is something that I kind of expected. But that's alright. If anything else, you now have a vehicle that you can drive that turns for you. There you go. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching. This is CypherDeck. Peace out.